When I become a priest, I call him a padre. Call it a father, and then I just call him padre. But we are in one place, we call it a bibil. Before he became a priest, he entered the St. Andrew's Theological Seminary.
That was weird. It was a video of stop and you go.
Really?
Yeah.
Thank you, everybody.
Oh, it's recording.
Because you have been, and you are always, brothers and sisters to me. Because according to Jesus Christ, my brothers and sisters are those who do the will of my Father. And for a long time that I have been with you, I had never any doubt that with God's blessing, I will always be surrounded by people whom I share the beauty and the treasure of our faith in the Lord. And you know, as I have said before, and I will always say, it's very difficult when I was at the early stage of my priesthood in the Philippines. Since you are so young, you do not have those revelations about the life. It's so difficult to express or to explain the mystery of life, that after death we have life. How can a 23, 25 years old explain it to the old people that life is like this, we will die but we will rise in eternity. And we don't even have enough experience. But when I went through the chemotherapy, that it's just a few hours. Because you see, an hour after my admission to the emergency room, an immediate blood transplant has to be done. Because my blood count is critically low. And I did not feel it. And And I had that revelation that I was about to knock on the door, and suddenly, I was alone, and suddenly, I said three times, "Lord, if this is my time, I'm ready." The third time, I was already in front of the door, and I was about to knock. The door disappeared, and I saw the face of my wife. And when I told my wife what happened, that was after 3 days, I told her, "I'm ready," and she told me, "I was not ready." "Don't do that." I said, "It's not for me. But just to let you know, I'm ready." I did not know that I was doing that well. I thought I was just a jolly fellow. When you sang, "I'm a good, jolly good fellow," I feel better. And then when my brother said that I am a good provider, oh my God, I am at the foot of my Lord Jesus, the good provider. So I said, it's a good feeling that some people can see this. Though I am not expecting this, so with this celebration and when they giving you the flowers that I love orchids. I don't know, I have been brought up with nothing. We sometimes miss, Willie did that mention, we sometimes miss milk meal. And how can I appreciate flowers? We cannot even afford it. But this time I have the flower, expensive flower, as part of my joy. Can you imagine how God is so great and so good? And I have a collection of friends and family members and even families. I am so blessed. I will never forget this, and I forgot. Probably I will have I will be forgetful sometimes, but this time, this thing will remain and retain in my mind. As I always say, I hope nobody will go through chemotherapy. It's tough. And it's very tough to say, every time they ask you, "How are you?" "I'm okay." But deep within me, I'm suffering. Every bit of your body is aching. But every time the doctor will come in, I will be standing up and say, "How are you?" "I'm fine. I'm okay." Because you see, I am convinced I'm okay because I'm not alone. The Lord is my shepherd is always the thing that is in my life. And I can say that with all sincerity because I know that the Lord being our shepherd, I'm not alone. I have a lot of you. I have, as my brother said, humble beginning. It's by the blessing of God. And you, each and every one of you, made it well and good. Miracle happens. I'm here. You are here. And I'm a jolly good fellow. Thank you very much.
Well, each and everyone, you just go in line and get your food while maybe somebody will be dancing here. I think I know Tito Ernie or the father Alina has her this dancing presentation just to break our speaking one another. So we'll call his group. Are you, you want to sing first? Okay, we'll sing first. Okay.
Sorry, there's bags for everybody to.